Flight. You think we could just, if I could just skip ahead? I just don't want to miss my flight.
Open the bag for me, sir.
I don't want to miss my flight.
Open the bag for me, sir.
I'm in a hurry.
What time's your flight?
But soon. I think they're boarding now.
Open the bag, sir.
Can and will be used against you in court of law.
A disaster.
Misleading every news broadcast, even CNN.
Governor, it would be nice if you would just stick to the script.
I was not going to let that man call me a racist.
Carter's fault, Governor. He's been real bold with the racist
He wants
rhetoric.
Us to panic, and then we do. We're just not disciplined enough.
Time Magazine's latest polls have us down by 3 points. The New York Times, they're going to endorse Jimmy Carter.
And then there's these rumblings the Carter folks are working with the Iranians to release the hostages right before the election.
The October surprise.
The public will see right through that.
What the public will see are 52 freed Americans.
Well, anybody else got something to say?
I think Jim does.
Mr. Casey, if I may, I know I'm the new kid on the block. I mean, I wasn't around when you all had your 20-point lead and all. But it seems to me we're just a little bit tight. Governor, why do you want to be president?
Oh, you don't know.
Well, let's pretend I don't. Just as simple as you can, distill it down to its essence, so to speak.
Well, we're at sea. The country's lost, and I know the way back.
How? How do we get back?
Get the government off the people's backs, fix the economy, and beat the Russians.
That sounds like a good direction to me. You know, I heard you give one of the most awe-inspiring speeches I have ever heard at the 76th convention. You just lost to Gerald Ford, my candidate,
because you stole our delegates.
But you came up onto that stage after you'd lost, and right off the top of your head, am I right? You made up that speech on the spot.
He did.
I wasn't even on your team, and you made me feel proud. You made me feel like this country had a purpose. Hell, you made a lot of folks feel like we had just nominated the wrong guy that night. You are the best damn performer I have ever seen in my political career. Now, maybe you have made a couple of gaffes, had a couple of bad days, but I think it would be a major mistake to try to keep you on a tight leash and not out in front of big crowds where you belong.
What are you suggesting, Jim?
We have to accept Carter's challenge to debate.
No,
let
no.
people see what you
we
think.
We can't afford any more bloopers and blunders.
Let people get to know
no,
who you really are.
No, we're down. We're not out.
We sure as hell are going to lose if we don't take a risk. So what do you say, Governor? Think you can handle Jimmy Carter?
Where is everyone?
Come on. President's in town.
Everyone's on detail, Judge.
Say right there.
In legal possession, Your Honor.
Right hand on the Bible. John Hinckley.
Yes, ma'am.
John Hinckley, do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth, so help you God?
Yes, ma'am.
Son, are these your guns? All that yours?
Yes, sir.
Were you planning to hijack a plane?
No, sir, no. I was just going to sell them.
These here are now property of the state. And there's a fine of $50 for concealed weapons, plus court fees, amounts to $1,250.
$6,250 all total, Judge.
And you now have a permanent criminal record. I do hope you appreciate that, son. So, if there will be nothing else, I am going to be getting on home for supper.
Good night, Judge.
Good night.
Night, Judge.
Good night, Millie.
That's it?
Here you go. I can go?
As soon as you pay.
With just one debate, so close to the election, it is likely to have an overwhelming influence on the outcome. As one Republican campaign official said today, it is the critical crapshoot for both men.
And through tax breaks, we will automatically induce the area of job creation in those areas.
President Carter.
What Mr. Reagan suggests is all fine and dandy if Medicare exists.
Oh,
but under Mr. Reagan, geez. Under Mr. Reagan, it will certainly be abolished.
Oh.
While he was still governor of California, he campaigned heavily against Medicare.
Ah, you know what? There he goes again. I'm sorry. It is nonsense. I mean, he is hammering away at me on this.
Yes, he has been, and yes, President Carter will.
Well,
Governor, your reaction was great.
Yeah, well, maybe I should just say that at the debate.
Well, you can't say that in the debate.
Why not, Rick?
It's not done.
Oh. Well, maybe it should be.
Okay, well, let's take a break. Thank you, Governor. You're doing great.
Governor, I have this for you.
What is it?
Research on all of Carter's positions. It covers everything from the Soviet Union to the honeybees.
Ryan, I'm just going to borrow him for a second.
Well, Governor, will you have a moment?
Sure thing.
Wait,
you all right?
Oh, yeah. It's just late.
I'm going to take that for you. Ronnie, they're coming at you with too much.
They're nervous.
Are you?
I'd be crazy if I wasn't, but I want to do this, Mommy. I mean, I can do this. This is the part where you say, Ronnie, you're right, you can.
I know.
Did you change your mind?
No, it's just we're coming at it so late. You've got so little time to prepare.
You know, they have been underestimating us all our lives. Right? In Hollywood. Then when I ran for governor, they didn't give us a snowball's chance. Look how that turned out. It's the same thing here. I want to show them, Mommy. I just need a chance to speak to the people. Standing next to Jimmy Carter. I can do this. I know I can. But just not without your faith. Have I got that?
You know you have.
Good. Because I want to beat that little son of a bitch. I'm gonna go see what it was.
Michael.
Miss Nansen.
Are you behind us?
What is it?
A binder crammed with garbage. Ronnie couldn't possibly digest it.
I believe this was Rick's doing.
He's fired. Do it. Now.
Now you can rewrite. But there's no way the right-wing Republican with a 20-year record of open affairs and statements on a record can change
the... Here's the other 22s I was telling you about.
It's nice.
The issue of peace and the control of nuclear weapons. On this great fundamental issue, all of the candidates are on one side except that Governor Reagan is on the other side. Back at the White House here.
It's the ROM RG-14. Pretty handy protection.
Can I change the channel?
No, you may not.
It's just depressing.
Emily, you need to learn what happens when we put soft men like Jimmy Carter in charge of our government.
this one and the ROM. Take both of those.
You got it.
Mr. Carter knows that Governor Reagan possesses a formidable television personality, but he believes that with give and take, Reagan can be made to look shallow, unknowledgeable, and despite recent changes in position, a man of the right wing.
No, I'm so happy you're here, Mommy.
Standing room only out there.
Well, everything hinges on this debate, but, you know, politics is just like show business. Mm-hmm. You give them a hell of an opening, you coast for a little while, then you give them a big finale.
And hopefully run for 8 years.
Yes.
I'm gonna go get to my seat.
I think you are more nervous than I am.
That's how it should be. Wrangle leg.
They're ready for the podium, sir. Good luck. Break a leg down. Yes, sir.
Okay,
the League of Women Voters is pleased to welcome to the Cleveland, Ohio Convention Center Music Hall President Jimmy Carter, the Democratic Party's candidate for re-election to the presidency, and Governor Ronald Regan, California, the Republican Party's candidate for the presidency.
That just isn't true. It is, I said, delayed the actuarial imbalance falling on us for just a few years without
John?
Taxes.
What?
Today is there,
what are you doing? You're missing the debate.
Expect to get out.
Just making a sandwich.
Is he eating again?
Oh, honey, you sure you want to wash downstairs?
Yeah.
John?
Wait.
Any prospects?
Don't you want to watch the debate?
I want to find out what's going on with you.
Nothing's going on. I'm trying. I applied.
Where?
Jack, maybe now's not the time.
I just want some answers. Whatever happened to your writing career? You want to take that class, right, at Yale? I paid for it. Remember? What the hell happened? And what about your plan to be a big-time rock and roll star?
Jack.
Honey, I'm just talking. You disappear for days on end, and then you show up out of nowhere. We don't even know where the hell you're going.
Why don't you...
Joanne? Please. John?
What? I don't know, Dan. I'm just... You wouldn't understand.
I just want to know where all this is headed, that's all. Your mom and I have been... Can I tell him? Yeah, I'm just going to tell him. We found another therapist. Actually, he's a psychiatrist. We'd like you to give him a try.
If I say yes, will you let me go downstairs?
Yes.
Okay.
So you see him?
Yes.
There you go again. When I opposed Medicare, there was another piece of...
All the nation. Here's my plan for the future. I ask the American people to join me. Yes, I would like that.
Talking to me? Talking to me? Talking to me? One day, a real rain's gonna come.
Ago.
Mr. Germain, your snap impressions of last night.
I thought it was sort of a draw. They were both very defensive. They both have a lot to be defensive about.
And David Broder.
Reagan talked to the country effectively. Carter talked to his specific constituencies even more effectively.
How many of you believe that tomorrow we're going to whip the Republicans all the way across this country?
But the imbalance on the map behind us is as striking as I have ever seen it working in this studio. Remarkable. One state so far called for a sitting president of the United States. And as I say,
hello?
The United States will be filling in on the map. There's an awful lot of the big ones.
Oh. Oh, yes. Yes. I'll hold on a second.
Isolated.
Ronnie?
And that's where he stands. So,
Ronnie?
I'm getting out of the shower.
It's Jimmy Carter on the phone.
What the heck does he want?
Oh, what do you think that he wants?
Oh, no, look, it's too early for the polls aren't
even
close.
You think he cares about the West Coast?
Yes, this is Ron Reagan. Hello, Mr. President. Well, thank you, Mr. President. You put up a good fight, and I want to assure you that I and my team, we will do our level best to make this a smooth transition. You too. Goodbye.
John.
What? What was the question?
If you couldn't be a musician, what would you be?
A composer.
Like John Lennon.
Lennon.
Or, Paul McCartney. More Lennon. Aim high, right?
Yeah, if that doesn't work out.
A writer. It's kind of my obsession lately. That and, the person I mentioned earlier.
The actress.
Mm-hmm.
Have you had any luck finding a job?
I don't need a job. I want to be famous. A writer. Someday.
Yeah, I understand. Have you at least tried to find a job?
Why don't you just ask my mom and dad?
I'm asking you, John. It matters because you're the one who has to take the initiative.
Initiative?
You need direction, John. Is there some way you can get to a better place? You know, a place where you want to be. Whatever that is, you're not going to get there unless you take action.
Excuse me. How do I get to the Blair House?
What's that?
It's where the president-elect lives.
The what?
Somewhere near the White House. What happened?
Yeah, the White House is on there somewhere. Someone put a bullet in John Lennon. Killed him.
John Lennon is dead. The world is over. I don't know why people want to live. I still think about Jody. She's all I really think about. That. John Lennon's death. Blended together. Mark David Chapman, the guy who killed Lennon. I wonder what it's like to be him, to be famous. Now, Jody knows who he is. Someone needs to save her. Just like Travis Bickle did in The Taxi Driver. Jody's the only thing that matters. And I just want her to know that. Come on. And don't let her hurt her. Sometimes I think that I would just rather see her not on Earth than with other guys. And I do not want to stay on this Earth without her.
So, what do you think? Open presents Christmas Eve or the next morning?
I just need to find her.
Don't we usually do Christmas morning?
Talk to her.
We did that one year, Jack, I think. But Christmas Eve is a tradition.
Let's do Christmas Eve.
In person.
John, what do you think?
Or something. I, Ronald Regan, do solemnly swear
that I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
That I will faithfully execute the office of President of the United States.
And will, to the best of my ability,
and will, to the best of my ability,
preserve, protect, and defend.
Preserve, protect, and defend.
The Constitution of the United States.
The Constitution of the United States.
So help you God.
So help you God.
Get you a different one if you like.
No. This was also Kennedy's desk. I'm keeping this. Nancy, see anything you want to change?
Don't get me started.
Mike, do you have that little...
Right here.
Thank you. Now, you, who are with me in Sacramento, will recognize this. And Jim, you're the new recruit, but there is no limit to what a man can do or where he can go if he doesn't mind who gets the credit.
Well, all of you in this room deserve a lot of that credit for getting us where we are today. And, Nancy, I raise my glass to you.
Sorry I'm late. Mr. President, Mrs. Reagan, congratulations. Big day.
What is this?
Something the President and I agreed on earlier, detailing my duties as Secretary of State.
Which are pretty clear.
Something we agreed on. I'm just making sure.
Well, it says here that you would have absolute power over all matters of foreign policy.
That's right.
You can't be serious.
Well, it's all very clear.
It's absurd.
This is hardly the time or the place.
Well,
Al, this would have to be run by the Joint Chiefs, the National Security Advisor. Secretary of Defense.
Well, the President and I have already discussed this, and
we agree it's unconstitutional.
Al, I think we can leave this discussion until later. Why don't you grab a glass of champagne?
Oh, thank you. I'll just leave that with you, and with your permission, I need to get back to the State Department. Again, congratulations.
Hillary knows how to kill a party.
It's getting worse. That's all I can say. Do you think that we ought to... Is there some place that he can go that...
Joanne. Sounds drastic, but is that an option?
No. No, absolutely not. I've worked with these treatment centers. If you go that route, you're just making an emotional cripple out of him. John is... Well, to put it bluntly, John is simply a young man who has had everything handed to him.
Agreed. No, I just don't get it, Doctor. A couple years ago, he was just a normal kid. Did you tell him, John? He was good at sports. He was popular with his friends. You were even president of your class one year, weren't you, John? John.
Yeah. Yes.
And then, bam, all of a sudden.
Look, the three of you need to make a contract. Johnny, listen, you need to be more responsible. Get a job and take control. And stop manipulating your parents. Mom, Dad, your job is not to bend. Can we all agree to that?
Talk about scrapping SALT II and bringing the Soviets back to the bargaining table. Is that something you plan to do now or in the future?
Well, I don't know about that, but I can say this. I know of no leader of the Soviet Union, including the present leadership, that hasn't made it their goal to promote a one-world communist state. The only morality they recognize is that which will further their cause, meaning they reserve the right to commit any crime, to lie, to cheat, to attain that.
Now, does that mean, in your view, that détente is even possible?
Well, détente has been a one-way street, and we have been on the losing end. I'll leave it at that. Now, thank you.
What do you mean, sir?
Now, Dick, the Russians do lie, cheat, and steal, don't they?
They certainly do, Mr. President.
I think the buttered popcorn is perfect,
don't
you? Don't
trust me, it's the cream.
Really?
Popcorn yellow would be malpractice to me.
George? Mommy? Ted? How's it coming?
Well, sir, for a remodel of one of the most venerated houses on the face of the planet, not too bad.
I'm sorry for all the mess, sweetheart.
Well, can't make an omelet.
Tomorrow morning, then.
I'll see you then.
Mr. President.
Did you see this morning's clippings?
Oh. Why do you read these?
Not for pleasure, that's for sure. Why are they so mean to me?
Why are they so mean to anyone who sells papers?
There's an article here that goes on and on about the fact that I own a gun, which is something that I casually mentioned off the record to a journalist. There's this one, calls me a dragon lady.
Oh.
I don't understand it. I cheerfully agree to do these interviews. I'm as open as I can be, and they tear me to pieces. I certainly hope that your people are doing a better job protecting you than they are protecting me.
These were all classified, completely unavailable to us before the election. Look on page 5, look on page 9. They're summaries. The Soviets are in much worse economic shape than we ever thought. I think if we do something now, we can win.
Win? Win what?
The Cold War. If we act fast, hit them hard before they know what happened.
But we can't just outspend them.
Why not?
Because our economy is on the verge of another recession. It's sick. The Democrats are saying it, the press.
Oh, who the hell cares what the press thinks?
We don't have. If we keep spending, We'll be worse off than the Russians.
I disagree. You've got the Russians in Afghanistan, a solidarity movement. Who knows what the hell happened there? Intel is pointing to a lot of movement inside Polish borders with a possible intervention by Russia. Mr. President, we cannot wait. The time to act is now. We outspend the Soviets on defense. We win.
Mr. President, forget the Russians for now. Our focus should be on the economy. That's the priority.
Well, David, Richard, thank you very much. Let us discuss this.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. President.
Thank you. David.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Well, you fellas know what I want. Let's make it happen.
Hello?
Jody, hi. I just need to talk to you, okay?
Yeah, well, I don't know you.
Did you get my letters?
No, I don't know. Listen, I gotta go to dinner, and I'm not supposed to talk to people I don't know, okay?
Well, I know you, I...
Look, I don't want to be mean. This upsets my roommates when you call, and that upsets me. Goodbye.
Jody Foster.
She's my girlfriend.
Yeah, right.
I know I asked for this, but he has got me meeting 2 to 3 Democrats a day. They have no sense of humor.
Well, that's for sure. I met with Leon Panetta and our California boys last week. Just a matter of time before they turn.
Well, if you need me to call, just let me know.
I'm afraid that's going to still leave us a whole chunk of votes short of passing this economic recovery bill.
Well, what is the latest count?
What is it, 25?
26.
26 votes short in the House.
It's that darn Tip O'Neill. He just won't let up, accusing us of soaking the poor and helping the rich.
O'Neill knows how to use the press to his advantage, that's for sure.
And the press has not exactly warmed to your plan, Mr. President.
Yeah, who knew that would be a challenge?
Mm. Still, we need to pass this bill. It is crucial that we do. Foreign policy is at a standstill. Now you've got this whole situation with the Soviets and Poland. This bill doesn't go through. I'm afraid it's more than just this bill that we're going to lose.
Well, how do you mean?
Well, Democrats smell blood, they go right in for the kill. And, sir, they get tougher than a rat in an outhouse. Point is, who wins this battle shows everyone in this damn town who's on top, who's in charge for the whole rest of your term.
Understood.
Hello?
Hi, Jody.
Who is it?
It's John.
John, oh no.
What's the matter?
John Hendricks?
No.
Hinckley?
Yes, Hinckley.
Listen, you understand this is dangerous, right? And it's not fair, it's rude.
I'm not dangerous, I promise. Have you been to a party?
No, we're trying to get some sleep. Do me a favor and don't call back, okay?
So you just don't want me to ever call you again?
No, but it's been really nice talking to you.
Well, how about just tomorrow?
During recent weeks, many of you have asked, what can you do to make America strong again? I urge you again to contact your senators and congressmen. Tell them of your support for this bipartisan proposal. Tell them you believe this is an unequaled opportunity to make government again the servant of the people. Thank you, and good night.
And we're out. That was great, guys. Thanks.
That was terrific.
Yeah. Jim.
Right on target, sir.
Mommy, how did that look?
Flawless.
It's just that we can't let up.
No, no, right? More to do. Understood.
What's next?
Well, I've got a few speaking engagements lined up, mostly unions.
Good.
Working class folks.
Well, it's my cup of tea, Jim. I'm a union man from way back.
President of the Screen Actors Guild.
Oh, I know, but these are hard sorts. They toe the union line. A lot of them probably didn't vote for you.
Well, we'll just have to change their minds, won't we?
Yes, sir. Also, I'm obliged to tell you that the new approval ratings just came out.
Pretty low, are they?
I'm afraid so. Democrats have been pretty successful at hammering away at you.
Jim, I trust you. Just tell me what to do.
That's what I'm saying.
Jim.
Yes, ma'am.
If you want the best out of him, you're going about it the wrong way.
I'm sorry, Mr.
You're tearing him down.
Oh, no, ma'am, I'm not.
Send him where you want, to whoever you want. You can even tell him exactly what it is you need him to say. But don't tell him that he's failing.
Chip O'Neill, Speaker of the House. I, too, just watched the President of the United States, and I must agree he's a super salesman. He and I don't agree in his plan whatsoever. I believe in the plan of fairness. Very easy to put the question. The question is this. Do you make over $50,000 or less than $50,000? If you make over $50,000, then you're for the Republican plan, because that's who it's geared for.
Before?
Well, it's $30 for a half and half. $20 if
no. I've never done any of this before.
Okay. So, John, you want to do this?
You look exactly like someone I know.
Dad? John.
Where are you now?
Let's go. New York.
What do you want?
A broke? Can you please send me some money? I want to come home.
Can I get back? Hey, thanks for picking me up. Before I left, again on the plane. What's that?
Antifreeze. Where'd you go this time?
Yale. Check out my riding classes.
You were supposed to have a job by now, John. You haven't lived up to your end of our agreement, John. Your mom and I, we had another talk with Dr. Hopper, and this is for your car. It's in the parking lot. It's cold out there. Second level, 128. Here's $200. You're on your own.
Dad.
You understand?
Yeah. Yes. Dad, I just want to thank you for everything you've done for me. Tell Mom. Thank you.
president is usually accorded a honeymoon period. Not so for Ronald Reagan, who faces steep opposition to his controversial economic programs. Many critics have even accused the president of trying to completely dismantle Franklin Roosevelt's legacy from the New Deal.
And what have you got today, Mommy?
An event for an art museum, huh? And then Ted later. We've ordered the china.
Oh, that sounds so great.
And what about you?
Well, I'm about to find out. I'll see you tonight.
Good morning.
Morning, sir.
Good morning, Mr. President.
Thank you, Colonel.
Big event today is your speech to the AFL-CIO.
Ah,
this morning we've got you thanking Hispanic leaders. It'll be quick. It's just a photo op.
Good.
A plan of attack. Take the bus to New Haven and kill Jody. Kill myself. Kill myself in front of Jody. Kill Jody and myself. Assassinate the president. Just end it. End this hell. Just end it.
Good morning, Chancellor Schmidt. Or should I say good afternoon? I was very sorry to hear about your father. Well, I lost my mom years ago, but there's not a day that goes by that I don't think of her. I take it you know about the latest development with the Soviets. Well, our intelligence says they are making movements inside of Poland. The more this solidarity movement shows its teeth, the more brazen Brezhnev gets.
Dear Jody, there is a definite possibility that I will be killed in my attempt to get Reagan. It is for this very reason that I am writing you this letter now. As you well know by now, I love you very much. Letters and love messages and the faint hope that you could develop an interest in me. Although we talked on the phone a couple of times, I never had the nerve to simply approach you and introduce myself. Besides my shyness, I honestly did not wish to bother you with my constant presence. I know the many messages left at your door and in your mailbox were a nuisance, but I felt that it was the most painless way for me to express my love for you. I feel very good about the fact that you at least know my name and know how I feel about you. And by hanging around your dormitory, I've come to realize that I am the topic of more than a little conversation.
Good morning, George.
Good morning, Mrs. Reagan. Is everything all right?
It's fine.
Can you tell Mommy? Tell Mommy I gotta go. All right? Okay. Bye-bye.
Are you going to help me?
Yeah.
Hi, Tim.
Afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, Ray.
Good afternoon, Mr. President.
Thank you. Well, hide in. Ready to roll.
However full of ridicule it may be, at least you know that I'll always love you. Jody, I would abandon this idea of getting Reagan in a second if I could only win your heart and live out the rest of my life with you.
This is 3.5 feet.
Hello, Ted.
Well, hello. We weren't expecting you till much later.
I know. I was feeling funny. I decided to come home early. George, thank you. I'm good for now.
Are you sick?
No, just an oddish sensation.
Do you want us to leave?
No. No, let's get to work. Maybe it'll take my mind off it, whatever it is. Now, tell me what your thoughts are about this room.
I
will admit to you that the reason I'm going ahead with this attempt now is because I just cannot wait any longer to impress you. I've got to do something now to make you understand in no uncertain terms that I'm doing all of this for your sake.
What about these things here?
That is the challenge.
Awful.
Awful is the word.
By sacrificing my freedom and possibly my life, I hope to change your mind about me.
Sir,
I gotta get the shots. This letter is being written only an hour before I leave for the Hilton Hotel.
Punctured a lung. Let's get to the hospital. Change of course. Get up to the hospital now.
Shooting at the Hilton. It's all over the television.
We understand that at least three persons have been hit, but we are informed by a...
0.5 at the... Can you turn that down, please?
Officer down at the Hilton where the president
is. White House phone, they always... Hello?
Ms. Reagan, there's been shooting. Your husband has not been injured. He is okay. Others have been shot. The president is on the way to George Washington Hospital now, okay?
George, why would he go to the hospital if he wasn't hurt?
Ma'am, I can't figure that out. I think he's probably just making sure everyone else is okay.
I'm going to that hospital.
You can't do that, ma'am.
Get me my car.
It's too dangerous, Mrs.
Get me my car or I will walk.
Rainbow on the move. Mrs. Reagan, please listen to me. This is too dangerous.
This is train wreck coming. I need everybody out of here. If they can go to the unit, take them to the unit. If they can go home, get them on those
things back there.
Let's go left.
Oh, no, no, no. Get him out. We need him right now. Get him out again.
collapsed at the door. He had no pressure. We got three lines in him, and the pressure's coming back up. We're waiting on a chest x-ray. I got a gas back. pH is 7.26. CO2 is 26. O2 is 84. It may be a heart attack.
Is that...
Could you take a big breath for me, sir?
I got good breath sounds on the right. One more big breath. I got no chest sounds on the left. Turn them on the side.
You're doing great, Mr. President.
I got it, Michelle. Oh, there. It's not a heart attack. That's a shrapnel wound. And I don't see an exit wound. Get a chest tube stat. Better get Van Aaron. We're going to need some Zylocaine here.
Sorry about you. I'm in an off full time. Breathing.
You're going to be all right, Mr. President.
What do you think?
We need to tell the public that the president was not wounded.
It's deeper.
Yeah, I understand. We'll keep this line open. Yeah, thanks, man. That's confirmed. He has been hit. Doctors are trying to figure out what to do next. Ed, you and I should get over there. David, you stay here. Larry, come with us.
Israeli, please wait for me. Please.
First, they thought it was a heart attack. They were wrong.
I have to see him.
I don't know that if that's possible.
I have to see him, Mike. They don't know how it is with us. He has to know that I'm here.
I'll make it happen.
Please.
Lynn Nasser has told reporters at the hospital that the president was not wounded. He was wounded. God. He was... The president was hit. He is in stable condition. All this information...
Mr. Vice President, can you hear me? This is Secretary Hay. We've had a serious incident, and I'm getting nothing but static on this end. Dave, get me Baker, Secretary. If you're still headed to Fort Worth, I recommend that you return back to Washington as soon as possible. Do you read me? Over. George, this is Al. Turn around. Turn around. Can you take and get a message to Air Force 2, Vitalex?
Yes, sir.
All right. Dear Mr. Vice President, in the incident that you would have heard about by now, you know the caliber of the bullet?
Yeah, my guys are telling me a .38.
That's too small to be a .38.
No, it's not .38. It could just be a fragment. Part of this could be in his belly. I need to do a peritoneal lavage. I need to take him to the operating room. I need to get this bullet.
They may have to operate.
What?
They found a bullet on his left side somewhere. They gotta get it out.
Jesus.
Now we're on a straight line from the hospital. Counselor, anything that is said, before it is said, we'll discuss at this table. Any phone calls that anybody gets with instructions from the hospital will come to this table first. Right here. Is that clear?
I understand exactly why you...
I will.
I said that, Fred. Fred, you just sit on him till I call you back, all right? Good feeling he has the succession papers in order.
Who the hell told him to do that?
Well, he is White House counsel. He probably feels someone needs to be in charge while the president is in surgery.
I don't know. Do they? Camp has national command authority.
Nobody transferred to Nixon when Eisenhower went under for his surgery.
If we do this, pass the power to the presidency level, are we going to panic the country, destroy the market?
Especially just 2 months into his presidency.
It's definitely very high risk.
Yeah, I say we stand pat.
And I agree.
Agreed.
I'm so sorry to interrupt, but there is a lot of blood coming from his chest tube. We know the bullet is in your lung, but we don't know where or what's been injured. You think we should operate? We can't take the risk of you bleeding to death.
Whatever you think is best.
Is he dying?
Yeah.
Who's mine in the store?
Mrs. Reagan, I'm sorry, but you can't go any further.
You need to stay with Mrs. Reagan. Ed, you and I. Is that Jim Brady? Sweet Jesus. Just keep me posted. If you can't reach me by phone, send me.
Thank you. Put it right here next to me.
Thank you, General. I've just given alerts to Strategic Air Command.
What kind of alert?
Just a standby alert.
They're not raising readiness.
Al, don't elevate it.
I'm not. That's what I just said, Don. We have the nuclear codes. Where do you put the football?
It's right here.
No one makes a move unless it's cleared by me. The helm is right here, in this chair. Constitutionally.
Al, I'm raising the alert status.
Do you have any idea what that would do? What kind of message that would send? We do not panic. God damn it, Cap!
Anybody interested in who did it?
Yes. The act alone?
John Warnock Hinckley. We don't know yet. No criminal record. He's 25 years old. Dropped out of Texas Tech. So far, he's refusing to give a statement. We're going to need to find out what organizations he belongs to.
Why isn't the Secret Service arresting me?
Secret Service doesn't arrest people. We do. Says he wants a lawyer. Apparently he has one in Texas. So get him. I haven't been able to reach him. You want to talk about the shooting?
I don't know anything about a shooting.
Maybe the feds have better luck with him once they get here in a couple of hours. They have jurisdiction. How do you spell assassinate?
A-S-S-A-S-S-I-N-A-T-E.
Jesus, do we need all the Secret Service in here?
I'm afraid so, Doc.
Horvath is still filling with blood. We're at 2,200 cc's.
Let's get him again.
Mr. President, we're going to take really good care of you, sir.
What are we putting this in, sir?
How you? Go back, sleep. You can hardly breathe.
Not to worry, you're just fine.
I hope you're all Republicans.
Mr. President, today we're all Republicans.
Good.
Our latest information is that President Reagan and Press Secretary Brady were both taken to...
Hello, Hinckley residents.
Hello, is this Joanne Hinckley?
Yes. Who is this?
This is David O'Hearn from the Washington Post. You're John Hinckley's mother?
Yes. Yes, this is Joanne Hinckley.
Were you aware that President Reagan was shot this afternoon?
Yes, Who are you? What do you want?
Ma'am, you are aware that your son was identified as the shooter, then?
What is this, some kind of a sick joke?
No, this is not. Ma'am, has the FBI contacted you yet? Ma'am? Mrs. Hinckley? I'm sorry, Mrs. Hinckley. Are you there? Mrs. Hinckley?
We are receiving word now that White House Press Secretary James Brady has passed away. He was shot along with President Reagan not long ago as he was exiting the Washington Hilton. Officials at the White House have confirmed this.
Is this true, Jim Brady?
No, I just checked. He's still on the operating table.
You better make sure that Jim Brady's wife isn't seeing any of this crap.
I will.
I'm going to send Speaks back over to the White House. Somebody's got to set the damn record straight.
That's a good idea.
Who the hell gave out that report?
I want to know every damn thing he says.
What's the status on this kid?
They found some loot. He
just got word Jim Brady is dead.
They're checking him out.
What?
All the networks have picked it up. Jim Brady is dead.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
We should get a statement ready on that.
We should.
Bow our heads. Say a prayer. Take a moment of silence.
They're still operating on both Jim and the president.
Sarah, the coverage is pretty sensational. These guys don't know what they're talking about. If I were you, I would stay away from the TV sets. Ron Jr. will be here as soon as possible. Patty, Michael, Maureen, they might not be here till tonight.
I've got to see about my son. I left him with my mom's cleaning lady.
He's fine, Sarah. He's fine. He's with your friends now.
How old is your son?
2. His name's Scott.
Nice in here.
I don't know.
Larry, we need an update.
I can confirm. I mean, we heard him on.
Dead. That is erroneous information.
Is he in critical condition?
That I do not know.
About President Reagan, do you have an understanding of how serious the chest wound is?
No, I cannot.
Okay, Larry, we've spoken to the president's brother. He has received a call from the White House. He's been told that President Reagan is in surgery. He's already received blood transfusions. Is your information going to continue to be this far behind our other sources?
No, Cheryl, we'll try to keep up. Now, as you know, when I first came down here, our initial report was that the president had not been hit.
Who the hell told this guy to go up there?
Josh,
we don't have
get Larry off the stage.
On it, the crap out of people. Yeah.
We need to get him off.
Larry, who is running the government?
I cannot answer that question at this point.
What's the status of the president? Jesus Christ, he's turning this into a goddamn disaster.
Wait.
Ow.
I'll be down here every 10, 15, or 30 minutes and let you know exactly what we know. And we'll also, when we don't have any more information, we'll let you know that too. That's all I have.
Come on, slow down.
Come through.
Make a hole.
Can we get more specifics?
Association with today's tragedy?
Raise the alert status. Only commanders to know. That way the men can't leak it.
It's Al.
We have in the situation room all the officials of the cabinet who should be
here and ready at this time. We have informed our friends abroad of the situation. Condition of the president, stable. Now undergoing surgery. And there are absolutely
no alert measures that are necessary at this time or contemplated. Now, if you have any
questions, I'll be happy to take them.
Crisis management, is that what's going to be put into effect when Bush arrives?
Crisis management is in effect.
Who's in charge of the government right now?
Constitutionally, gentlemen, you have the president, the vice president, and the secretary of state in that order.
And should the president decide to transfer the helm to the vice president, he will do so.
As of now, I am in control here in the White House.
He doesn't have that authority.
And in turn of the vice president.
The secretary of state is not after Bush.
No, he's fifth after Tip O'Neill and Strom Thurmond.
He's lost his mind.
There's surgery now underway to remove the round.
Before the surgery, the president was conscious.
Right angle. How's he doing, Danny?
His blood pressure is stabilized, sir. It's all 102 over 54. His estimated blood loss is currently 3,000 cc so far. We're still giving him blood.
I see the seventh rib is shattered, and I just can't find the damned blood. This is bad.
They're strong men. Both of them. They'll get through this. Yes, they will. Doctor, we have the lateral view.
Okay. Let's take a look. Okay. This is an inch from his heart. We don't have much time. Let's keep working.
Al, the chairman is reporting 2 Soviet submarines headed for the Atlantic coast.
How close?
A nuclear warhead could now reach us in 10 minutes and 47 seconds. That's 2 minutes closer than normal.
Al, are you listening to this?
I've ordered bomber crews to move from alert in their quarters and on the post in their planes. That should shave off 3
minutes. I said up there. God damn it, Cap. I'm not a liar. I said there'd been no increased alert.
Well, I didn't know you were going to go up there and say that, Al.
Let me ask you this, Cap. Is the submarine's maneuvering affecting your decision? Or is it the fact that the president's out cold and can't decide for himself?
No. is that I have complete command authority over U.S. forces in this situation. I am doing what I'm supposed to do.
You better damn well read the Constitution. You better read the Constitution.
Doesn't look like a guy that just shot the president. There's a business card with a psychiatrist's phone number.
Go for it.
It's from a magazine. Maybe a crush. That's a Connecticut phone number. He won't talk motive, or if he acted alone. Seems fascinated with the Secret Service. Maybe you should give it a shot.
Yeah.
Sponge stick. How long has he been under me?
It's been 85 minutes, sir.
Jeez. Sponge stick again.
What are you thinking, Doc?
I think you're going to need to step out of the backup.
Who has given us an update on the situation. We are told that the president is in surgery now, that he was wounded in the lung. We knew, of course, earlier that he was hit.
Ready? Pick up. Come and pick up. Give me a step.
Where is this damn thing?
104 minutes, Ben. Come to that chair.
Maybe we should just close him up. He's lost over 50% of his blood, and I can't stop the bleeding while I'm searching for the bullet. Maybe we should just leave it in.
Having a good time there, Ben?
Yeah, wonderful. Just wonderful. Right angle.
John? Steve Cola, Secret Service. How you doing?
My wrist hurt.
Look at that tank here for you. You know why you're here, John?
Mm-hmm.
In violation of U.S. Code 1751, the attempted assassination of the president. We just need to know, is anyone else involved?
No. It's just me.
Can you tell me why you did it then? Come on, John, we already know things about you. Because you've been checking.
I've been seeing a psychiatrist lately, I can tell you that.
Well, what's that all about?
I have no direction in life. I talk to my lawyer.
You know, John, any stuff you can tell me now will help you on down the line.
Yeah. I think I need to talk to my lawyer.
Okay.
Is this on television?
No, it's not being taped.
Not what I meant. Is this on television?
Yeah. National television.
Will it affect other people? Will they be pulled into it? Will they see it?
You mean like your friends and your parents?
And others.
We know about the phone number in your wallet, John. The one from Connecticut.
Well, if you know that, then you know everything.
Said he would be coming out of surgery shortly.
His condition is good and stable. What you just heard?
No, we just heard. Fantastic news.
Hinckley. I suppose a 70-year-old man is able to withstand what must be the natural shock of surgery, certainly of being shot.
I'm so happy for you. Thank you. I'm going home now. The doctors say he's going to be sedated all night. They're strong men. Remember?
The doctor, Dr. DeMeo, was emphasizing the potential danger of the small caliber bullet, which can apparently do so much damage as it's moving around inside the body. Probably what? Explode, I mean. No, it doesn't explode. I mean, that's the dumbed-down kind.
Thanks. Colonel Jones. Grab the football. Soviet subs are turning around. There's no threat. There never was. The Soviets were merely changing battalions.
I just spoke with Baker. Vice President should be here by 1900.
Guess you can stand down now, Al.
Reagan, that tube is in there to help you breathe. I don't want to have to tie your hands down, sir. Okay? All right. You want to write something down? Here you go.
So apparently, the bullet ricocheted off the limo.
That's why it was flat and so hard to find.
The all-important dairy bill.
Oh, I should have known that you fellas wouldn't let me miss a staff meeting.
Well, it is essential the world see we're still open for business and that you sign.
And not Al Haig.
Oh, no.
Long story.
We'll tell you about it later. For now, just focus on getting better.
After you sign the bill.
That should put the fear of God into the Soviets. This kid who shot me. What was the guy? What was the guy's beef?
We don't know. Seems he was just some crazy mixed up kid.
I was hoping it was the KGB. But on second thought, that he wouldn't have missed. What was the young man's name?
John Hinckley.
Hinckley. We'll pray for him.
It's very important to him.
I mean, I don't know if we would have had the same results if he wasn't. I did want to warn you, though, that things may be different now.
What do you mean?
Well, he lost a lot of blood, and we used universal type O negative. You know, that's the type. I'd much rather used his type, but we weren't sure at the time, and he was about to go into shock. Also, the transfusions were cold. So that combined with the anesthesia and the president's age, seeing that he is 70.
What are you trying to say, Doctor?
It may be a long recovery. And in some ways, the president may not come all the way back. This was a traumatic event, Mrs. Reagan. Your husband will likely have a very slow recovery. Into this hospital. I would like to walk back out.
Thank you. Griffin on the phone.
Oh, and how is Merv?
He's fine. He says hi. And, he thinks he has someone who might be able to help us. Do you remember when he introduced me to that astrologer?
No.
Well, he did. Her name is Joan Quigley, and she is very good. I mean, she is really very good. She has a knack. And, okay. He told me that she predicted that March 30th wasn't going to be a good day for you.
Are you telling me this woman knew I was going to be shot on March 30th?
No. That's not what I'm saying at all. What I'm saying is she could have warned us. If we had been in touch with her, we might have been on the lookout for something, and maybe you would never have gone and given that speech.
Oh, so you... You want to get advice from this woman?
Yes. In fact, I already have been.
Mommy, you and I, we might think this is a good idea. But,
yes.
And maybe even Michael. But everyone else, I mean, if they found out...
Nobody would find out.
But you can't keep secrets around here. You know how...
We would keep it secret. We would. You have been far too open, Ronnie.
What?
You have to protect yourself, and if you're not going to protect yourself, I will.
I have people to protect me.
Oh, yes, and look how that turned out.
But the press...
I don't care about the press. I don't care about your staff or anybody else. I care about you. And this is not going to happen again. Do you hear me? I could not go through this one more time. I would just die.
You and me both.
Oh, that's not funny. I'm sorry. Please. Will you let me hire an astrologer? I know it sounds crazy, but I have to.
Spared for a reason.
What do you mean?
Maybe
it wasn't an accident. Maybe the rest of my days here on Earth, I belong to him. With a capital H.
From the State Department. The Russian president is testing us.
Well, I want it to be personal, Al.
Why?
Well, because it is personal.
Mr. President, this is the worst possible thing you could do right now. The grain embargo. That's our only bargaining chip, and you're just giving it away.
Well, I don't see it that way.
You know the Russians will view this as weak. Worse than Carter. And make no mistake, they will take advantage.
We'll just have to take that chance, won't we?
Well, what about your supporters? They didn't elect you to
that. That is enough, Al. That is enough.
It's your conservative
I
basis.
Said shut up! Now, why in the hell can't I open the doors to bargain with Brezhnev? When I was in Sacramento, I had a lot of people giving me advice, and they wanted it all or nothing, and they wanted it all at once! Well, I learned a long time ago negotiating union contracts that you seldom get everything you want. And that's what I told these radical Republicans, and that's what I'm telling you now, Al. Why would I risk losing everything if I can get 75% of what I want? The last time I checked, I am in control here. Now, please, send the letter, Al.
Understood.
As is.
Understood, sir.
The president insisted.
After Jim and Ed cowed him into it, Michael, he was not to travel yesterday.
I apologize. You have my word, it won't happen again.
It mustn't.
I get it. I understand.
You don't get it. You don't understand. It is your job to protect him. He's changed. Don't you see it?
Honestly, Nancy, no.
He has.
The doctor said we're lucky.
I don't want to hear it. I don't need your advice. I don't need your comfort. I need you to listen to me.
Understood.
Thank you.
But Mike, you'll handle the bells and whistles.
Of course.
It's very important that we take advantage of this time. Mr. President, your poll numbers are through the roof.
Well, they should be. I got shot. You're like a hero in one of your movies. Unbelievable.
Yeah, the economic recovery bill is ready to go for a vote, but this goodwill, it won't last very long, so we need to do this speech before Congress soon.
O'Neill says he thinks we're taking advantage.
Well, let him see what happens if he even tries to stop us.
No, he won't. He already said he won't. Agent McCarthy and Officer Delahanty. Only survivor who won't be able to attend is Jim. What's the latest? Doctors say he'll pull through, but they doubt he'll walk again. And there is some talk, Mr. President. He suffered some brain damage.
Damn.
What do you say as a tribute to Jim? We let him keep the title of press secretary no matter what.
That's a great idea.
I agree.
Well, shall we talk dates for the speech?
Can we wrap this up? Doctors only give me a couple hours a day.
Of course. All right, we've got the 27th or the 28th. It's a Monday or a Tuesday?
Monday's no good.
What's wrong with it?
The First Lady feels it's bad for the President.
Is there something going on I don't know about? Mr. President?
Oh, Jim, let's just do Tuesday. Monday, everyone's asleep anyway. I know I am.
The President and his aides, of course, do not concede their plan is a gamble. But Mr. Reagan really doesn't intend to argue the point tonight. He is going to Capitol Hill not to debate his program,
but to build a new and, he hopes, irresistible wave of emotion behind him.
Ooh. Here. Let me.
Thank you, Mommy.
All in all, the president told Congress to feel they must be both because it is right and because it is his.
Thank you, the American people, for giving me the great honor of allowing me to serve as your president. When the Lord calls me home, whenever that may be, I will leave the greatest love for this country of ours and eternal optimism for its future. I now begin the journey that will lead me into the sunset of my life. I know that for America, there will always be a bright dawn.
We'll preserve for our children this, the last best hope of man on earth. or we'll sentence them to take the last step into 1,000 years of darkness.
I will not make age an issue of this campaign. I am not going to exploit, for political purposes, my opponent's youth and inexperience.
We can win all together, but let us at least be sure of one thing. If it should be our destiny to fail, let's not fail because we weren't together, because we didn't stick together.
Faithfully execute the office of President of the United States. A few months ago, I told the American people I did not trade arms for hostages. My heart and my best intentions still tell me that's true, but the facts and the evidence tell me it is not. As the Tower Board reported, what began as a strategic opening to Iran deteriorated in its implementation into trading arms for hostages.
Mr. Gorbachev, tear down this wall.
Thank you.